Hi there, Sam Sorbo here for the Accidental Homeschooler. So, video three of the second week of 10 steps to the fall, to the autumn where you're going to perhaps make the decision to keep your children home and educate them yourselves. And I'm very excited for you on this journey. We've talked about assessing your space this week. We've talked about assessing your children and figuring out what your children's needs are. And importantly, we've talked about how fluid the task of educating your children becomes. And so I've been really trying to impress that upon you, that you make a plan because you need a plan, but you also need the flexibility to change the plan. And today I want to give you a tip that I think is very important. Don't listen to naysayers. Just don't listen. Just don't. I remember we were at a speech and debate event. My children did speech and debate, which I highly, highly recommend. And I was sitting with some parents, and she said to me, "Oh, Classical Conversations, which is the education curriculum, basically, that I've chosen for my kids." She said, "Oh, you know, it's way too rigorous. You can't do speech and debate and do Classical Conversations." And she went into this whole sort of justification for, now there are families who just, basically they just do speech and debate. So every topic becomes a research topic and their children are researching and writing papers on that topic to better prepare them for the events that they'll be competing in and stuff like that. And then I guess they just throw a math and a science curriculum on top of it, but they don't do any other sort of prescribed thing because there are families who they load up the motorhome and they're traveling every weekend or every week with their kids to go do tournaments. And God bless them. I mean, I think that's awesome. It is a really great education for a lot of kids. But in any case, she said, "Yeah, you can't do Classical Conversations and speech and debate." And I'm sitting there going, I do them both. So wow, I don't know how you do that. That's just crazy. Well, what are you sacrificing? I mean, how can you get that all done? Home education is flexible. But don't listen to the naysayers because they don't know. They don't know you. They don't know your kids. They don't know your situation. They don't know. And there are a lot of naysayers right now with COVID coming out and disclaiming and deriding home education with absolutely no evidence, right? And this is where the thought part comes in, absolutely no evidence, and saying that it's going to be disastrous for families and they don't want you to think about it. And I want you to think because I know how great it is. And I also know how afraid I was, how extraordinarily fearful I was, that I was somehow going to break my children or ruin them somehow. And the opposite is true. You save them. You save them from the schools. So don't listen to the naysayers. Remember your reasons. You know, we made that list of pros and cons and then we refined it. And perhaps today is another day for you to look at it again and refine it again and figure out what the goal is. Because that's really the most important thing. If your goal is education, then the schools aren't getting that done, right? If your goal is college prep and career readiness and you want a remote-controlled individual who does what the government tells them to do, okay, then send them to public school and off to a four-year college and all that. Okay, I won't get into all that. Don't listen to the naysayers. And if you need more positive reinforcement, just tune back to my YouTube channel right here. So subscribe right now, okay? And also, if you wouldn't mind sharing these videos with other people, I would really like to get this word far and wide. We can do a great work here for families in the United States. We have an incredible opportunity to do this. You've been given a gift. So think about it, try it on, keep going, tune back in more 10 steps to the fall tomorrow. Sorry. Okay. Bye.